This summer, a renowned brand of Chinese ice cream ignited public curiosity when it was found to be non-meltable after being exposed to a heat of 31 degrees Celsius, or about 88 degrees Fahrenheit, for more than an hour and a flame from a lighter. This brand of ice cream, Zhongshui Gao, isn't the kind sold on the street by vendors with no license. It's the expensive kind with a price tag on par with the luxury American ice cream brand Häagen-Dazs. Its most expensive product sells for about $9.90 in US dollars. After the experiment by one consumer at the end of June, many Chinese have done similar experiments on various products by this brand under similar conditions. They have confirmed that this brand of ice cream is indeed hard to melt. Ice cream not melting under heat goes against human experience. The public has therefore asked a series of questions, such as, how come it doesn't melt under heat? What is added to it? Is it safe to consume? In response, the company publicly issued a statement saying, it isn't scientific to judge the quality of ice cream by baking it or heating it under the sun. It deliberately mentioned that the use of carrageenan in the product was in line with the national standards. To this, one netizen responded, Zhongshui Gao has its bottom line after all. At least it doesn't harm the poor. A little bit of carrageenan is fine once in a while. Even if it's not fine, pay more attention to it in your next life. This comment received a lot of support from the online community. Carrageenan became a household name in China in 2012. On April 9, 2012, a well-known anchor of CCTV, China's top official media, said on his social media Weibo, "Stop eating yogurt and jelly, especially for children. The inside story is horrible. I won't go into details." His counterpart, a reporter from the Investigation News Department of the Economic Observer, also revealed on Weibo, "One day you throw out a pair of old leather shoes, in the blink of an eye, they will enter your stomach." In fact, this is the highlight of this year's CCTV 315 gala, but unfortunately, the film was not aired. Although CCTV didn't follow up on the relationship between leather shoes and yogurt and jelly, in its weekly quality report, aired a few days later, it was reported that capsule manufacturers were using leather waste to make pharmaceutical capsules, which had flown into the pharmaceutical market in China. The official news agency also showed how leather shoes were refined into gelatin in private factories. The mentioned incident triggered a huge controversy. Back then, an online post went viral in China. It reads, "In 2012, leather shoes are in great demand. From now on, when I want jelly, I will take my leather shoes and have a lick. When I want yogurt, I will take my leather shoes and have a lick. When I catch a cold, I will take my leather shoes and have a lick." Overseas consumers who want to experiment with the ice cream mentioned earlier can buy it on Taobao, a Chinese shopping site. Here you can see the advertisement for their product, which says, "You don't pay if it's melted." Back in 2016, a report by PricewaterhouseCoopers said that shoddy food products cost the global food industry $40 billion a year, and Chinese consumers were particularly worried about food safety. Their confidence in domestic foods plunged since the tainted formula incident in 2008. In 2008, the Sanlu Group, China's largest infant formula company, was found to have added the chemical melamine to its formula, damaging the urinary tract of infants and children and causing kidney stones. It affected at least 300,000 infants and children. Since then, Chinese dairy brands have been repeatedly exposed to scandals. The imported baby formula has seen a huge increase in sales as a result. In September 2021, the Center for Product Export Development of the Ministry of Agriculture of the Russian Federation published a report stating that the world's total exports of whole milk powder were over 2.7 million metric tons in 2020, of which nearly 23% was bought by China. The main country supplying milk powder to China is New Zealand, which exported 561,000 metric tons to China. The report also said that in 2020, China bought a respective 13%, 9%, and 4% of the world's exports of skim milk powder, butter, and cheese. Not all Chinese people can afford or buy imported formula. After the toxic formula, fake milk powder appeared in China. In May 2019, Chinese media reported several companies used protein-type solid drink mixes, posing as the special medical formula, and sneaked it into hospital stores. In May 2020, one such case was exposed that a company in Hunan province sold solid drink mixes as a special medical formula to parents, causing deformities in children's skulls. In 2021, another company in Qingdao did the same gimmick, resulting in intellectual disability level 2 in a 3.5-year-old girl in Chongqing, China. The girl's father, Mr. Huang, told overseas Chinese media, "I never thought of the formula as problematic because it was very expensive. It sold for about 360 renminbi or $53 for 360 grams, so I never suspected that there might be something wrong with it. The advertisement said ketchup formula, and I had thought that my child's health wasn't great and she could use a bit of ketchup. Life is certainly very tough right now. She needs 24-hour care. I can't go to work. I am divorced, alone with my child. Never mind. I feel really sad." And this exact company quickly changed its name after the incident. Exposed posts about shoddy food products have spread like wildfire on Chinese social media in recent years, adding to people's confusion and mistrust.
这山东临沂的,
this is a peach from Linyi, Shandong province, and we transport and sell them in Shenyang, northeast China. Be careful when eating peaches. Look at all the preservatives.
敢吃吗这样打,会不会中...
Will it be poisonous to use preservatives like this? Don't worry about it. No? Just sell them? The smell is too offensive. In this beautifully packaged box of mooncakes, there is something hidden that the human intestines cannot digest. I ate 2 pieces and my stomach was so bloated. I can't digest it. Let's see what this meat floss is made of. Why can't it be digested? Let's see. It can't be washed off. This is the meat floss showing. Let's see what it actually is. It's all cotton, and it's blackish. There are impurities inside the cotton. Is it from the cotton used in the hospital or inside the quilt? It is not clear. Was it sterilized or not? We don't know. This is the factory that produced it. It's called Sugar Chew. Chinese food is reaching overseas through various channels, especially in supermarkets run by Chinese, including the ones by Taiwanese immigrants, where most of the food products come from mainland China. Chinese food products have been recalled by other countries around the world. In February 2021, GLG Trading from California recalled nearly 100,000 pounds of condiments imported from China without proper inspection procedures. The official website of the U.S. Food Safety and Inspection Service, or FSIS, indicated that the recalled products were a hot pot base made in Sichuan province. The statement said these products were heat-treated and contained beef tallow. China is a country ineligible to export beef to the United States. The products hadn't been retested by the FSIS and didn't carry the federal inspection mark. The FSIS recall ratings are usually 3 levels, 1, 2, and 3. This recall rating is 1, the highest level, which means the health hazard may result in severe and adverse health consequences or death. However, many websites still carry this product. This is one of the larger cases of overseas recalls. In fact, customs in various countries have given China a relatively lenient environment when it comes to importing Chinese food products. Let's look at the documents released by the Chinese government to see which food or related substances have been rejected by the customs of other countries. In the first quarter of 2022, the EU Rapid Alert System for Food and Feed recalled 39 cases of Chinese food imports, an increase of 5.4% compared to the same period last year. There were also 49 cases concerning contaminated food contact materials and 2 cases concerning animal feed. Regarding agri-food products, the most frequently notified categories by the EU Rapid Alert System for Food and Feed are other food, food mixtures, and fruits and vegetables. The number of notifications in the category of other foods, food mixtures, has increased significantly, which mainly involves 2 types of products. First, Chinese specialty foods, including canned vegetables containing white lilies, seaweed, and bean sticks. Second, intermediate products such as raw ingredients and additives, including flaxseed extract, xanthan gum, and capsules. Moreover, the intermediate products were all notified for the reason of containing ethylene oxide. The report reads, "It can be seen that the EU regulation of ethylene oxide has reached deep into intermediate products." The report specifically alerts Chinese exporters of xanthan gum. It states, according to the EC regulation, the export of xanthan gum to the EU needs to be accompanied by an official certificate certifying that all sampling and analysis results of the product comply with the requirements of the regulation, and that the sampling and analysis results need to be attached to this certificate. China ranks first in the production of xanthan gum globally. You may not have heard of it, but you and your family have probably had it, as they are prevalent in a wide range of imported Chinese foods such as ice cream, tomato jelly, yogurt, soy sauce, 8 treasure porridge, cheese, bread, and cakes. It is also used extensively in industries such as paints, fire extinguishers, toothpaste, cosmetics, ceramics, paper, printing and dyeing, and petroleum. It is a sticky agent, similar to the carrageenan used in the non-meltable ice cream mentioned at the beginning. When a little is added to fruit juice and milk, it turns them into jam and yogurt. Chinese media have reported that many steaks sold in China's supermarkets are actually glued together with ground beef. The glue agent used to bind the meat includes carrageenan and xanthan gum. Let's go back to the Chinese government's notification. Regarding notifying countries, the largest number of notifications for agri-food products from China were made by Spain and the Netherlands, with 7 cases each, followed by Belgium, Germany, and France. Unlike the EU, where food recalls are notified through the Rapid Alert System for Food and Feed, and other consumer products are notified through RAPEX, in the US, recalls of different products are issued by different government agencies. Food recalls are issued by a Food and Safety Inspection Service under the Department of Agriculture, the Food and Drug Administration, or FDA, and the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, or CDC. In the first quarter of 2022, the FDA reported 193 rejections of Chinese agricultural and food products to the U.S., an increase of 36.9% year over year and up 2.3% from the same period last year. Most rejected agricultural and food products were vegetables, fruits, and bakery goods. 28.0% of the products were rejected for containing melamine or its analogs. 26.4% of the products were rejected for containing filthy, rancid, or rotten substances, or were unfit for consumption, and 22.3% of the products were rejected for labeling problems. The most rejected item was enoki mushrooms, 73.7% of which were rejected for containing the pathogenic microorganism Listeria monocytogenes, followed by bread rolls rejected for containing melamine or its analogs. In the first quarter of 2022, the ACCA in Australia withheld 3 batches of food products from China. The main reason for the recall was the presence of an undeclared allergen, such as nuts or almonds, which could cause a reaction in any consumer allergic or intolerant to nuts if consumed. In the first quarter of 2022, the Canadian Food Inspection Agency detained or recalled a total of 54 batches of Chinese food, a year-on-year decrease of 18.2% and a month-on-month decrease of 30.8%. The main product categories recalled were other foods, mixed foods, fish and aquatic products, condiments, fruits and vegetables, prepackaged foods, nuts and nut products, and seeds. There were 19 recalls of other foods, mixed foods, mainly due to the risk of allergens, milk, peanuts, and salmonella contamination. 14 recalls of fish and aquatic products were mainly due to the risk of milk allergens and norovirus bacterial infection. 6 recalls of condiments, mainly due to the risk of salmonella contamination. 5 recalls of fruits and vegetables, mainly due to the risk of insect foreign bodies and Listeria monocytogenes. Customs in various countries have arguably stepped up their inspections of Chinese food products, but they may still be loose. Let's look at an example. According to internal federal records, Canadian officials of the Food Inspection Agency found problems with 889 food products or ingredients imported into Canada from China in roughly 2 years, from early 2017 to February 2019. The documents reveal that many Chinese imports didn't meet Canadian standards. Examples are foreign metals found in gumballs, insects found in instant noodles, and unidentified harmful substances in spicy squid snacks. Yet the Canadian Food Inspection Agency's quarterly reports show that only 4 shipments of food from China were refused entry into Canada during this period.